What's going on, guys? Welcome to another Modern Monday. This time we are taking a look at Black-White Pox deck. It's kind of similar to the deck that won the GP. Not the one that won the GP, but the one that top 8 of the GP. It got 12th. I think it got 12th. Which kind of put Smallpox decks on the modern map, so to speak. So basically, our strategy is disrupt things with all these 1-mana cards like Inquisition, Fatal Push, Mana Tithe. Then we have Bloodghasts and Lingering Souls and 8 Planeswalkers to kind of out-attrition them. And hopefully that does it. We got this one Anguished Unmaking, like fulfilling the role of a Vindicate in the deck. We also have one Never Return, which is going to go here. It's never going to go there. It's never going to go there. To play the role of, you know, it just kills things like Tarmogoyf's Primeval Titan, I guess. And then you can also just get rid of a graveyard card if you need to, which is pretty sweet. I don't know how I feel about this card in Modern, but it's got some versatility to it, which is nice to have in the main deck. We also have Collective Brutalities, supplementing Inquisitions and Thought Seizes, so we have multiple ways to discard. One of the coolest interactions in decks like this is the Smallpox, the Flagstones of Trocair into Urborg, so that you turn 2 Smallpox, you get to sacrifice your Flagstones, and then you get to search your library for a Plains, so presumably a Godless Shrine. I am a little bit upset with myself. I did not replace these before joining the league. So we just have these Amonkhet, these Hour of Devastation basic lands. Not really my thing, but what can you do? This is a very nice sideboard, though. We got Stony Silence, Rest in Peace, Full Mana Mage, Damnation, and Leyline. So this sideboard does everything I want a sideboard to... I can't move anything, okay. Does everything I want a sideboard to do, and I have no criticisms about it. Maybe a way to kill enchantments, but I think we can let it slide because this is a very, very well-tuned sideboard with not a lot of one-ofs except for the Rest in Peace, which basically just supplements Leyline of the Void as a 5th graveyard hate piece. So, if you guys are watching this on YouTube, be sure to check out the article that's actually written along with the videos on channelfireball.com, and we'll see you guys in the round. What's going on, guys? Welcome to a round with Black-White Smallpox. As you can see, doing something. as you can see, we're doing something a little different. I'm adding a webcam, a little cam feature. So let's see if you guys like this or not. I don't know if it's could give the video more personality. And this way, when I sound super salty, you'll realize that I'm like smiling or laughing or whatever. Definitely gonna keep this hand. We can go Steam Vent into Shambling Vent into Marsh Flats, discard a Bloodghast. If we can draw a Flagstone, okay, that's fine. We can actually play Bloodghast, then next turn Smallpox, discard Bloodghast, sack Bloodghast, but that doesn't make any sense. We might as well just, Alright, well, we have 5 cards in our sideboard for this particular matchup. So that's pretty cool. It's always troublesome because I don't know how to deal with it round one, though. I'm just like, well, I guess we just kind of lose to it. They're also... Good old OTM Shank 82 is running 2 different kinds of street raids, which is just not... It's not right. You just need to not do that. This is where they go Exile Simian's Spare. They can't Demonic Dread. There's no targets. And they can't Violent Outburst because they don't have a green... Cycling now is interesting because it gives me more options. Whoa, Fairy Macabre and 6 lands. That is not good, sir. Not good. I mean, if they draw any Cascade card, they're just in business. So that's pretty sad. No, what? Oh my god, Magic. Get it together, dude. What is with this lag? So... What did they play? Verdant Catacomb? Alright, we'll get rid of that guy. Trying to figure out if there's any way we can sequence this that makes it good. I don't know if Smallpox is great here because they just discard a land. This is a weird deck to play Smallpox against too, because it's just like they don't really care if the cards are getting discarded. They're like, oh, I discard my cycler. All right, sounds good. I was just gonna cycle it anyway. Also, Fear Macabre gets rid of Bloodghasts from our graveyard. I'm just gonna play a Bloodghast here. We could Smallpox, but then we have to get rid of a Shambling Vent, which I'm not a huge fan of. Yeah, I think we're just gonna pass, make a Gideon next turn. Which we can't do if we Smallpox. Are you streaming right now? So I'm not ghosting because my Twitch name is the same. Alright. I'm gonna pop out graveyards. Stomping Ground. Alright, so we know three of the lands in your hand. And we're just going to crack it a Godless Shrine. Oh, look at that basic land just staring me in the face. That non-fancy base. Okay, that's enough. That's enough lands. Gideon. Get in there with this guy. I guess we just make a dude. Make a soldier. Thought I told you. Alright. We're just hoping to dodge the 8 cascade spells, I guess. We can also save Smallpox until they play cast 1, 2, 3. They have 5 creatures in their graveyard. I'm pretty sure like if they just cascade into something, we're dead, right? Wooded Foothills. Here we go. Demonic Dread on my knight. Oh, just cycling Monstrous Carabid, so you have a million dudes in your graveyard. It's not looking good for us, guys. They just have such inevitability that we do not have. So we can actually activate a Shambling Vent. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Smallpox puts them. The problem is if they have Violent Outburst, they just cast it after we activate Gideon. And then we actually have to lose Gideon too, because it's real bad. And we also lose Shambling Vent if that happens. That's pretty rough. Alternatively, we can make an emblem. Attack for 9. I'm terrified of a Violent Outburst here. It's just so bad for us. I think we're just attacking with everybody. We just need one turn. Literally one turn. Can we get that one turn? Alright, well, I think we did it. Create another dude. Play a Godless Shrine. Alright. Moment of truth. Or they didn't care and they just want to do it at the end of the turn. No, okay. So at worst, if they kill everything, we get Bloodghasts back, we get to Gideon, and we have 2 Shambling Vents and Smallpox. I think we're in good shape here, but this is hard cast that dude, huh? That's a desperation play if I ever saw one. Interesting. What land did you play? A swamp? Alright, so we now have a mountain in hand. And 3 other cards? What are they? Okay, well, it doesn't matter, I guess. Sweet! Wow, I did not think we were going to win that one. Get Never Return out of here. Get these Lilianas out of here. And I think our main deck is just terrible. We're going to bring these guys in. We're going to bring Damnations in. And we're going to bring Fulminators in. And we're going to bring Rest in Peace in. Maybe. Maybe we'll take the Damnations out. Damnations are great because if they do end up going off, we can recover pretty easily. Not a big fan of Fatal Push because it doesn't kill anything. It kills very few things in their deck. Liliana, we don't really want to make them discard because it's kind of just helping them. Damnation might be better than Smallpox here. Because again, they're discarding cards. And like if they do end up going off, I think Damnation's probably just better to have. I think this is probably a better configuration. Let's find out. Got four ley lines of the void, so let's see if we can hit one in our opening hand. It's gonna be three in our opening hand. There are gonna be none in our opening hand. I do like Urborg and Flagstones with Smallpox, though. That's pretty good. So I think we're gonna actually keep that. And ideally we'll draw Blood Gas. Top card's always a ley line if you don't hit one in your opening hand. So just worth keeping in mind that this is gonna be a ley line. Oh, it's just a Lingering Soul. Oh, actually, that's a pretty reasonable card to discard here, so I'm okay with it. Cycle. Unless you're playing Death Shadow, in which case, you do you. Pop out these graveyards so you can see them, so my head's not in the way. So they're going to go to 5 cards. So it's yeah, I think it's just Smallpox here. Next turn we can Fulminator Mage. And it's pretty easy to discard like a Godless Shrine or the other Flagstones. Alright, let's see what happens. I hate making them discard though. It just feels bad. We can probably discard Lingering Souls and then cast Thoughtseize. We can go Lingering Souls, Thoughtseize at some point. Actually, next turn we'll probably Fulminator Mage, and then we'll play Thoughtseize and Lingering Souls. So I think we're actually just discarding a land here. Might even be Shambling Vent. I like the long-term applications of Shambling Vent, but I do not like that it comes into play tapped. Next turn we can... it's got to be Shambling Vent, I think. Discarded a Living End. Alright, well that's a completely irrelevant card to have in your hand. So that's just fine. Yeah, we'll get another Godless Shrine. Well... yeah, it's fine. I mean, they're never not going to kill our land is the thing. So, like, if they have Fulminating Mage, they're just going to kill Urborg. If we got a Plains. So, like, we're in the same position. And in this case, they just kill Godless Shrine instead, and we keep Urborg, so... And then Flagstones is still a Godless Shrine, so it's just totally fine. Inquisition... So if they have Simeon Spirit Guide, they can Simeon Spirit Guide here and get two dudes back. But I guess we get Fulminator Mage back, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, we're just going to Fulminator Mage here. Keep them off their third land. And next turn... Here they go. They're going to do it in response, I bet. Yeah, just kill this instantly. So that it's in the graveyard for when they... I assume they're going to cycle another dude. Yep. All right, sweet. So I think we're safe here. They could always go sack this for a green. Simeon Spirit Guide twice, and then Violent Outburst, but I'm going to assume that's not going to happen. All right, sweet. Yeah, so next turn they can play a land in Simeon Spirit Guide and get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dudes back. It's so hard to deal with. It's so many guys. And we didn't hit any of our 5 graveyard pieces yet, so... Also, if they have Demonic Dread, there's just no target for it. The interesting thing about Demonic Dread is that they actually have to have a target for it. Otherwise, nothing happens. I mean, you can't cast it, is basically what I'm getting at here. Violent Outburst, you can cast at any time because it doesn't need a target, but... Without any creatures on board, we're pretty free to... not worry about Demonic Dread. Well, that's pretty interesting. It's Inquisition first. There's no reason to take damage if we don't have to. I assume you'll cycle something in response. Or not. Oh, there's a Violent Outburst right there. What in the earth? Oh, you just don't have a way to cast it. Wow. And a Fulminator and a Beast Within. So how do we get rid of Fulminator Mage, and then we collect a Brutality, your Violent Outburst? Like, Beast Within is just fine, because then we get a... we get a dude, is what I'm saying here. So you have land, Beast Within. That's pretty good. Yeah, definitely not gonna... I have no reason to play Thoughtseize here. Like, I don't care if you Beast Within one of our lands. You can Beast Within one of your own lands, and that's probably just worse for you. But we have more than enough lands to... Blackleaf Cliffs... And if they top deck a Violent Outburst, we're in bad shape, but we could always Thoughtseize, check again, and then Lingering Souls. So, trying to dodge Demonic Dread here. They're at 9? Wow, that is a lot of damage they've taken off of Fetchlands and Street Raids. And 1 from Smallpox, that's not nothing. Beast Within, probably one of your own lands, I would imagine. One of my lands, and the Flagstones. That's interesting to me. That had to be the worst choice, right? All right. Just hoping to dodge cascade spells, I guess. I don't think we can recover if they have a cascade spell. Which is sad, because we got pretty close. So near hand is a swamp and one other thing. I guess we'll find out what it is. Oh, it was a Street Wraith. Okay. They're at 6? Gush! This Blood Ghast is lethal. They literally had to top deck it. They had to hit it off of this Street Wraith. And, of course, they did. That's fun. That's hilarious. Literally dead on board. That's Just amazing. Damnation? No, just another blood gas. I think we're dead, right? Six. I mean, block here, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, that was amazing. Wow. They were literally dead on board. They had one hit. These guys don't do it. We can make two more blockers. We have three blockers. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. I guess we're not dead. Which is interesting to me. Yep, I don't know why these cards do not need to be revealed. They do have Simian Spirit Guides, which is interesting. They also have Ingot Chewers. Still in the main deck. Alright. Well. Six. Unbelievable. I can't even handle it. Like, we had two spirits, a fulminator, no, not a fulminator mage, two spirits, a blood ghast, well, two blood ghasts, I guess. My hand just brushed the mic, sorry about that, guys. I guess we're blocking everything. Yep. So, block six. Block. Nope, not you. Block you. So, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Go to 2. Kill a land. I think their red is more important than their green. Plus, they have two red sources, two green sources, so it's not really. If we can top deck another blood ghast. So there's your swamp. Alright, so we can deal 4. That'll do. Alright, well, that was close. Sometimes you get real lucky. And we still didn't draw any of our 5. And you can see a situation like that is just where damnation's going to shine. So, all right, let's try again. I think I'd rather have the damnation than the other anguish, the anguished unmaking. That just makes total sense, right? Take out the anguished unmaking. Like, I'd rather not exile. If they're in a position to have these dudes on board, they probably have multiples. So damnation's just going to be better in that situation. So. I guess we'll see what happens. All right, let's try Leyline. No Leyline. I swear to God, I've never drawn a Leyline in an opening hand before. Urborg, two Urborgs is kind of like a mulligan. I don't think this hand is good. So I'm going to ship it and see what happens. Wow, this is just worse. All right, I'm going to keep it because I don't want to go to 5, but this is not a game-winning hand, guys. We're going to keep Inquisition because we have no reason to cast it yet. So in that case, we probably should have played Godless Shrine first. Typically, you just run out the Inquisition. You're like, let's see what you got. But they don't have really relevant things to do until at least turn 2. I mean, they could technically cycle a guy this turn and then just Living End next turn to get one dude back. I don't think they're going to do that, though. So we could probably wait until turn 3. But now I'm just going to hit, and then we'll go to the shrine, and then we'll hit again next turn. So, despite... Oh, just a handful. Okay, well, that's good. How nice. How nice. We're doing well this game. Doing well. This is a solid match. Solid Living End match. We have 5 pieces of sideboard hate for this deck. We have drawn 0 in 2 games, and also... They've gotten a little lucky with their... They had the top deck, Demonic Dread, last turn to Cascade. And we just mulliganed to six, and it was just terrible. And then we whiff on Inquisition, so. So, what was no land played yet? Street Wraith and Horror. Oh, yeah, it's because that was that EOT. All right, so Verdant Catacombs, sure. Well, I guess we know you have Ingot Chewer and Monstrous Carabid still, so I guess we're guaranteed a hit of something. But not looking good here. And I guess we'll just get rid of Beast Within. I don't know. Oh, we had the Beast last game. That's what it was. We didn't have... It wasn't Bloodgast, Lingering Souls. It was Beast, Bloodgast, Lingering Souls. Because they gave us the Beast. So. Okay, so Swamp, Carabid, Foothills, Ingot Chewer. What is in your hand? Cigar to Carabid. I think the Carabid's gone. So I think this is your... I don't know. I Magic Online just puts the new cards on top of the old cards, and then if you don't clear them, then you just forget which was what was what. So, yep, that's pretty good. So long, Shambling Vent. Ah, they have a swamp in the hand, too. I think. I don't know. It doesn't matter. I don't care. Oh, yay. This game is over. We are basically dead here. I mean, if there's no creatures on board, then it removes Demonic Dread as a cascade out. They also don't have any green sources yet, but they do have a Wooded Foothills, right? Sure. Why not? I mean, they could just actually suspend this. I don't see why you wouldn't just suspend this. I'm just going to get rid of it. Because, like, that's definitely a real thing. I assume this is your hand now. Choose one to keep. Alright, let's get a land here. I mean, we're still in it if we can draw, like, Rest in Peace followed by a solid threat, but all signs point to no right now. Oof. That's desperation right there. What land do they play? Swamp? Alright, so Swamp is gone. Ooh, that doesn't do anything right now because Ingot Chewer just kills artifacts, right? Yeah, sure. Let's play Fetid Heath and yeah, sure. I hate that Leyline doesn't actually get rid of the cards that are already in there. Like, that's what you want Rest in Peace for. But it doesn't also affect your Bloodgasts and your Lingering Souls, which I can see why they only added one Rest in Peace. Because that will get rid of everything. And that's pretty bad for us. But they don't really have anything right now. Their hand is Mountain Ingot Chewer. Ingot Chewer could just be fine by itself. We have a bunch of cards. I would love to have a way to draw some cards in here, though. In our deck. Not in play. So now we have Ingot Chewer Mountain. Pretty sure I'm just going to kill this dude. Two modes. We will -2/-2. And we'll just take a look at your hand just in case. If you had something, you would have just cast it, right? It's obviously Mountain Ingot Chewer. Probably land. It just doesn't make sense that it's not. Like, if you had Demonic Dread, you would definitely target your guy and get back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Ingot Chewer, 6 guys. Like, not even a question. If you had Violent Outburst, you would do the same thing. So I will just assume you didn't. You're not sandbagging a Violent Outburst to EOT do it. Maybe you are. That's possible. But then you're just going to do it in response anyway. So none of those things really prevent Violent Outburst from happening. So might as well get 2 life out of the deal before we die a horrible death. Oh, actually, it would only be 5. And Getchuber's not going to go to the graveyard. So that's good to know. You're 100% getting a green source. You're not putting in a planet tapped, which is good. All right. I could see them playing and get you over here. How are we not dead? Mountain. Is that the same? All right. Ingature, one other card. The good thing is, like, there's no creatures in play, so they can't actually cast Demonic Dread. There he is. Gideon. It's actually pretty good. Do we make 2 more? I think so. Let's just go ham. It's a 3-turn clock. Gives him 3 draws, so. We have no creatures in our graveyard, though, so if they do Living End, we're just donezo. I think we can take 3 here. I don't think that's a problem. Because they are on a 3-turn clock. Just don't draw anything in 3 turns, that's all. Demonic Dread, right off the top. There it is. Okay. I just can't. Oh, boy. Damnation? Do I have similar luck? No, I got a swamp. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, that's all we need to see. All right, and I'll see you guys in the next round. Welcome back to round 2. And we'll keep this hand. It's a little slow, but we got a... I don't know, turn 2 Inquisition, then we don't have to take damage. Maybe. And then turn 3 Lingering Souls. Depends on what they do, obviously. So Forest. Into Experiment 1. I think we definitely don't want to take damage here, so we're just going to Godless Shrine and Inquisition next turn. Because we can only take 1 thing out of their hand, so... If we take 2 damage to take a thing out of their hand, we're just taking more damage anyway. Ooh, Kessig Prowler. Alright, I see what's happening. I'm getting a little aggressive here. Is there going to be a second land? No second land. Intriguing. Well, Blood Gas can't block, so that guy's definitely not coming down here. Let's see what you got. It's going to be 4 more 1 drops. Whoa, boy. I guess we get rid of the Rancor here, because that seems hard to deal with, whereas everything else is pretty easily manageable with Lingering Souls. Alright, well. Not feeling great about this. This is an aggressive, a little aggressive deck here. If they get a land, they can play Colonian Tusker. Another 1 drop. Alright. Well. Taking 4 here. We do get the Lingering Souls, which is nice. Gets to block Tusker and Experiment 1. Well, that could be good the following turn. We could also just go Godless Shrine, Lingering Souls again. We could also double block this Experiment 1. Just don't hit a land, that's all. We know your hand. It's Dungrove, Tusker, Vines. And Tusker is going to make both of these guys bigger. Oh, and they hit a land. Okay. It's always the timing with our matches. They always have it the exact turn they need to. Couldn't give you 1 more turn. I just want 1 more turn of you not having a land, but alas, it was not meant to be. Interesting. No, we're definitely blocking here. Sh- Sure. Oh boy. Liliana's not that great here, so Tusker is gone. I think we're just gonna. No. Just kind of Lingering Souls again, and then next turn we can double Lingering Souls. I feel like we're a little behind here. I feel like Smallpox would be reasonable in this matchup just because sacrificing any of these sizable dudes is fine. That's good. That's okay. I could see us taking six here. If they attack with Prowler, we're just blocking Prowler, but otherwise I think we're just taking six. And double Lingering Souls to make a bunch of dudes. Yeah, let's do that. Well, we can also Thoughtseize, go to two. Yeah, we have to kind of want to take this. Not ideal, but let's get a Plains just because if we draw an Urborg, it's just more versatile. Going to two here. Taking Vines, I imagine. Because I can actually cast that. Dungrave Elder doesn't seem terrible. Gonna go Lingering. And the problem is this gives us six guys. We can actually chump block here just to get Soren online next turn. But we have to block everything. So actually go block, 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 block. And then it leaves us two spirits. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Depending on what happens here, could be fine. Could be sad. Hard to say. Avatar. Sure. Well, that does evolve. Alright, so we're blocking them. We're jumping that guy anyway, because we have to. That guy having trample and reach is pretty annoying. This is pretty okay. So now we can just go block, block, and then we have 8 life on board. Which is pretty good. I don't want to throw two more guys away on the Tusker because it's just bad beats there. That could be reasonable. Could Liliana make them sack something, discard Bloodghast? So another hand is Dungrove Elder. I think we're going to Soren here, but we got to be careful because this guy does have trample, so... Alright, moment of truth. Can we survive? Why don't they get Vigilance, too? God, I wish they had Vigilance. This guy has reach, though, so... Yep, just gonna pass. Next turn, Liliana make them sack a guy, followed by Collector Brutality to gain two and kill something is pretty good. Unfortunately, we pretty much have to block every one of their creatures. That's actually fine. That is completely fine. This is not a creature we care about terribly. I just hope they don't attack with the Prowlers because we can kill one easily. I'd rather not trade a spirit for a Prowler. I feel like they have to attack with everything though. We can let the Avatar and the Colonian Tusker through, and we can double block here. But then they remove two counters, it's still a 2-2, and it still kills two spirits, which is pretty bad. So we probably actually block here instead. And then block Prowler, Prowler. So then we would take two here, we take 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, but we'd gain 8, so we'd go to 1. Oh, how nice. block. The problem is collective brutality doesn't kill any of the wolves. This experiment one is pretty annoying. So we could block like this. We take 8. No, there's no reason not to block with both of these guys, right? Just kill this dude. I feel like we're dead. They just have too many guys. We can't double block and kill this guy. We could double block and kill this guy, which is probably better, but they're trampling over anyway. So we're just taking 3 more if we do that. Well, we're taking 4 now. If we double block here, we're taking 3, 4, 5. So we're taking 1 more if we do that. Yeah, I guess this is fine. It's not ideal. I hate losing all of our creatures, but... And still at 2. I guess we could make... Collective Brutality not killing anything is pretty brutal. So we make them sack a guy, we make a blocker. We go to 4, then we can take 3 from the Tusker, and... I think we're dead. Maybe we're not dead. I mean, that's... I don't know. Do I wish Collective Brutality was an instant? Yes, I do. Blood Gas not being able to block is pretty problematic. Yep, figured you would sack that guy. So the problem is, like, we block here, and we still take 4. So yeah, I think we're dead. Yeah, we might have been able to block differently. If we got the Trampler off the board, we'd be at 1. But then they'd still have a 3-3. And we'd go up to 3 from Collective Brutality, so we'd still have to block both of their creatures no matter what. Yeah. I mean, they just had an... We go up to 4. It doesn't kill anything. Why don't you kill anything? Why can't I choose the same mode twice? Why doesn't Blood Gas have haste right now? Eh, might as well try, I guess, right? Alright, let's see what happens. Maybe they attack Liliana. They're not attacking Liliana. But I would be remiss if I did not at least make them do it, so... Both at me. Yep, alright. Alright, let's try again. Boy, this deck is not doing well. I don't know how this 5-0'd so many times. Let's bring in all these damnations. Angerstone making is a little aggressive. So is Thoughtseize. Alright, that seems good. Don't think we care about any of their cards in here. Fulminator Mage could be good. You know, because it kills their basic forests. I will play first. This hand seems good. We'll keep it. Alright. How awkward is it to just keep up mana for mana tithe? Pretty awkward, but nonetheless, I'd rather just take 2 and get rid of a an experiment one. Plus, they could also think it's path, so. Beautiful. Doing the Lord's work there. Fatal Pusherino. So let's play this. We'll let them play a guy. We can then collect a brutality, killing their guy, gaining two. Unless it is a Colonian Tusker, in which case I'm just going to fatal push it because we cannot. Yep. All right. Kill all your things. This is going better for us. Yeah, I'm still not going to play Bloodgast. Just too much. It's too easy of a discard to collect your brutality, so. Uh-huh. Well, that's frustrating, but not terrible. If only collective brutality was an instant. That's the world I want to live in. So now we can actually play Gideon next turn and collective brutality, kill this guy. They're probably going to Rancor this, though. Make an ally. My nose is itchy. Yep. it's like clockwork. Got another one? So you kill my Gideon? The old double Rancor hand? I have a good feeling about it. I think you do. I think you're trying to figure out how it can go wrong. No? Okay. Well. Oh, now you want to kill my Planeswalker. Okay. I will block. Alright, you had a pump spell. Yep. Seems good. I have no idea what's going on right now. This is fascinating. It's very fascinating. Let's see this. Leatherback Baloth. Avatar. So they don't even have third land. So we can get rid of the Avatar. The Rancor, unfortunately, goes back to their hand, which we could have taken with Inquisition, but if they had another instant or sorcery, I'd rather know if they have that so that we can see whether we want to use the other mode on Collective Brutality. Does that make sense? So, like, if we kill it first, we don't know if we want to use the other mode because then we're just throwing away a card in hopes that they have a sorcery or instant. I think I'm going to get rid of the Avatar here. Because we're going to kill this guy and it's going to have a counter on it. Negative and life cast. Okay, well, I just paid this one, so I don't know why. Oh my god. This program is beautiful. It's just a work of art. Yep, both of these things come back. Hard to deal with. We're gonna lose to this mono green aggro deck. This is quite hilarious. I felt good about this opener with Mana Tithe, Fatal Push, Gideon. But then they had the old Rancor aspect of Hydra. You know, like you do. And they still have a full grip of, like, Dungrove, Leatherback, Kessig Prowler. And Rancor. Let's not forget the Rancor. Coming in hot. Coming in for five. Maybe I should just play this in Modern. Maybe this is just the deck to beat. So we have Leatherback, Dungrove, and whatever you drew for the turn. Yep, that's a good one. That'll do. Unfortunate. And we'll get this Bloodghast back. Would you like to use this ability? Okay. And we got to create a vampire otherwise. Well, I guess Soren's going to die anyway, so it doesn't really matter, but I'd rather be able to trade with the Stranglegeist at this point. Of course, Rancor just giving Trample is just kind of dumb, so... Okay, so that's what you drew, I think. God, Rancor just makes everything unbeatable. Oh, boy. I'm just going to block here because I'd rather get the Stranglegeist off the board. Sure. So, 2/2s. Got a Damnation. Got 3 Damnations in the deck, actually, but... We have yet to draw those against any deck, Living End or this one. So, Flagstones. Well, Bloodghast can't block, so I guess we're getting in there before we take 6. I don't understand how this deck did so well. I guess it didn't face mono green aggro, and I guess it drew its. Graveyard Hate against Living End. Those are my guesses. So drawing your Graveyard Hate against Living End, not facing Mono Green Aggro. That's your key to getting top 16 at a Grand Prix. And to 5-0ing a Magic Online League, apparently, as well. All of these are crucial elements. Don't forget them, kids. But how did you 5-0 the league? Well, you see, I drew my sideboard removal for decks it was relevant against. You understand. No blocks, because that is not how Bloodghast works. And the end. Alright, so 4, 5, 6... I guess we have one turn. I don't know what it will do. I guess we can hope that they go land Leatherback Baeloth, and then we go land... Or no, we go, what do you call it? Damnation. And then we go... Smallpox, I guess? To get rid of their Dungrove Elder? There you go. Or they can just draw a pump spell. Like you do. And concede. Yep, there it is. That's fantastic. Oh, boy. All right, we'll see you guys in round 3. Good times. Good times. Welcome back, guys, to round 3. Not going super well for us so far with our black-white smallpox deck, but... You keep on keeping on, as they say. I'm going to keep this hand. We have a ton of 2 and 3 drops, so I think we'll be fine. We can start with Event, kill something early, and then have 2 Planeswalkers. They're going to Goblin Guide us, which is just fine. I wonder if there's enough life gain in this deck. Hey, that's a free card. Hey, that's pretty good. So, do we want to just kill this Goblin Guide? We can't Marsh Flats for a Swamp because it's right there. So we'd have to actually get a Godless Shrine, which means if we play Marsh Flats, we can't actually kill Goblin Guide this turn without taking 3. Sounds bad. I kind of want to kill this. Yeah, I'm just going to play Swamp here. We'll discard like a Fetid. We'll discard the Marsh Flats, actually. I don't need to be taking no damage. Plus, it gives us a chance to draw another land, which is nice. Yay! Alright, kill it. Oh, nice. Oh! 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 So let's play Flagstones, then we can play Urborg and Smallpox. Yeah. And hopefully they'll play a guy. That's my hope and dream. We do lose a life, but hopefully that won't affect our grand plans. Here comes a Boros Charm. Just Lightning Helix, okay. Well, they only have 5 cards left, so that's good. Let's discard a Fetid Heath here. I think we want all the Shambling Vents we have because they gain us life, and they attack and they block. And if they go down to 3 cards, that's pretty reasonable. Plus we can go next turn Fetid Heath into Planeswalker, into Shambling Vent Planeswalker, into Shambling Vent attack with Fetid with Shambling Vent. So we'll see if that does anything. I don't know, we could just die. Discarded another Lightning Helix. Good deal, good deal. Sack of the Wooded Foothills, that's interesting. So they don't have a green source now. I will use this ability, and I will get probably a basic Plains, because we have an Urborg in play. One argument is that we could get a Godless Shrine, because that would prevent us from drawing the Godless Shrine, so that we don't actually have to take the Boros Charm to the face. Oh, just a third Lightning Helix. Okay. Alright. Everything's in increments of 3, so whether we go to 10 or whether we go to 11, it doesn't really matter. Well, that could be good. That could be real good. Let's play Event. And we'll 2-mode this bad boy. Target you. Target you again. So they can probably only play one thing here, but it's going to be a Skullcrack, so it doesn't really matter. Now we'll get rid of a Fetid Heath. If we can play Gideon and then Solemn Visitor. However, if they cast Skullcrack and then we get to discard another card, we go to 8 and then only have 1 card in hand. And then we get to go Gideon into Sorin. Sorin can make Gideon a 6-5 and we gain 6. That's pretty good. Yep, of course it's a Skullcrack. Every opponent we've played had exactly what they needed. Oh, we'll take the other Skullcrack, sure. Good times. Good timerinos. Let's see what happens. I think we could win this match. We just might have to get a little lucky. They could actually just go Lightning Bolt, Suspend Rift Bolt. We go to 6. We go to 2. There's a Rift Bolt. And then we just die to... Yep, this is exactly how we figured it would go. So they just have to top deck a thing. Gideon Areno. Just draw a land and we're good. Just draw a land. One land. Just not a 3-mana burn spell, or a 3 damage burn spell. That's it. And then we get to gain 6 life, 8-9 life. That's all you need. Literally just not a burn spell. That's all. If you can draw land, that's cool. If you can draw a creature, that's cool too. Okay. Well, we're dead. Sure. Cannot win a game to save my life in these matches, so. Alright, it's just funny at this point. Okay, Damnation's not good, Leyline's not good, Fulminant Mage not good, Rest in Peace, Sony Silence are not good. So we just submit like this and hope everything works out, I guess. Fulminator might just be better than an Anguished Unmaking, I guess. It doesn't matter. I guess it doesn't matter. And there's the Anguished Unmaking right now. Alright, well, this is unfortunate. So we didn't actually play Urborg in order to predict a first turn. Ugh. I just can't even handle it, man. Oh, that game was ridiculous. Like, we literally, again, it's like one turn, the exact turn, they had to top deck a burn spell, and they did. So, like, if we had one more turn, we could have literally gained 9 life, which puts us so far out of the realm of winning for them. It's not even close, but... So, living in, they needed to top deck a Cascade spell, and they did. They had one card to do it, and they did it. The green deck had to top deck a pump spell, which they did. So, yeah, I don't know. Like, our draws have been terrible, and their draws have been great. Now, granted, that's not to discount the fact that we have definitely probably made play mistakes, right? No amount of bemoaning my opponent's luck ever excuses me from having played perfectly, because I don't. I don't play perfectly by any stretch of the imagination. So I'm definitely it's definitely a factor. It's definitely a real thing. But watching the opponent get a little lucky when it counts is also a thing. So now we have Mana Tithe and we have Fatal Push up here. If we can just draw, give us a Plains. Oh, Bloodghast. That's a good card against the mono red deck. Just kill it. Really? Just gonna play Shambling Vent and keep up. I'm not gonna take 2 to play Lingering Souls. I'm also not gonna just run out of Bloodghast that doesn't do anything. I think it's much more relevant if they try to Boros Charm us or Skullcrack us or whatever to be able to Mana Tithe it. And then next time we can cast our Lingering Souls. Yep, that is perfect. Yeah, printing 4 damage is probably the best we could ask for as far as Mana Tithe goes. Leyline of Sanctity might be one of the cards that I could see putting in the sideboard here, but I mean, it's only good against burn. It depends on how relevant burn is in the metagame, right? Like, if it's not a huge part of the IRL metagame or even the online metagame, it's just not even worth really including. Especially when your sideboard slots are so limited as it is. Like, all your sideboard slots are very, very relevant in this deck. Inquisition. See, the good thing about Inquisition is that it's good at any time. Like, I can play this next turn, and it's still good. Because as long as you nab a burn spell, you're just fine. You're doing the same. We're preventing the same 3 damage this turn or next turn from a burn spell. And if they don't have any cards in hand, then they don't have any burn spells. So yeah, like, this is not a deck where you have to, like, pick when you're going to use your Inquisition and be like, oh, I got to use it early or else they're going to, you know, combo off on me. No, they're just going to burn you with one more spell. But they're not even going to... They can't cast it, so... Oh, that's not what we want to do. We're going to Inquisition first, and then we're going to actually play Liliana, make us both discard so that you have to get rid of 2 cards. And then we're actually in reasonable shape, I think, but I've said this before. I've felt this way before. I've been lulled into this false sense of security before. Sure. Searing Blaze. That'll have to go. Big Lils, and we can discard Bloodghast pretty easily. Man, how come you didn't play that Lava Spike? I don't see why you wouldn't play Lava Spike there. We could discard Angerstone Making with the idea that we never actually want to cast it in take 3, but it's still just useful enough, whereas Bloodghast will always come back, so... I'm actually going to only attack with 1, because if they draw a Goblin Guide or a Monastery Soul Spear, I will just block it because it just feels better than not. So until we can get a bunch more presence on the board. Yep. So, lava spike. We know nothing about your hand. I'll actually, I keep forgetting to pop these guys out so that, Rift Bolt. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. Sorin? Gideon. Actually, maybe we just attack with... Do we just attack with Shambling Vent? No, because they can't kill us this turn. So what we can do is make a guy. Next turn, we can attack with Shambling Vent. Eh, so long. So, yeah, next turn we're going to attack with Shambling Vent and make an emblem so that we gain three, which puts them on such a clock that they have to actually deal with... Well, see, what's going to happen is they're going to draw Skullcrack or a Tarkus Command here. Probably not a Tarkus Command because we haven't actually seen any green cards. But they're going to draw Skullcrack. That's going to be the one card they draw. So when we go to activate... Oh, they didn't. This is great news. We actually get to do a thing. Oh, that's even better. All right, that's game. That's just game. Eesh. Make this dude a big. And plus this dude. And that should do it. And we'll just activate Liliana here, because why not? So we get to attack for 13 and go up to 19. Yep, alright, sweet. Our opponent did not have to see that happen. We're going to take out this guy for this guy, because if they have Boros Charm, or not Boros Charm, it's a land. Sacred Foundry? Then we can just kill it. It's whatever. But, I mean, it just has to be better than an Anguished Unmaking, which I never want to cast, ever. So... This hand is interesting. But it's got a lot of playables, so I'm going to keep it. I feel like the burn deck never has to mulligan unless they literally just have zero lands. And they always get the Goblin Guide. Actually, it's going to be about a Starry Swift Spear. Yep, okay. That's how you do it, I guess. Oh, man. Sometimes I wonder, Magic. Sometimes I wonder. Can't actually kill it this turn either. Why can't Blood Gas block? Come on, man. I'm a vampire spirit. Things just go right through me. Sure. Whatever you say, dude. Taken two. Well, total. Not this turn. But, you know, I've taken two in total. Ooh, I hope they play a Goblin Guide. Then we draw land, and then we can play Fatal Push on both dudes. Ooh, that's all I want. Because we don't have any more lands now, so we kind of need that Goblin Guide land assistance. Take two. Boros Charm my face. No, nothing. All right, I'm intrigued. You didn't play anything to pump the Monastery Swift Spear. You didn't play anything end of turn. What is going on? Pre-combat? Eidolon. Okay, we're just going to go double... Fatal Push you now. And Fatal Push you as well. Actually, we should have waited for them to cast something, right? They're probably going to cast something, so... Could have waited. That was a little hasty, but then also they could just... Get their land. I guess we give them the chance, so. Here comes a Goblin Guide. Yep. That's insane. Yeah, they would have taken two. So if they die, Lingering Souls, and we have two lands. Okay. Feels bad. Yeah, if there's not a land on top, I'm pretty sure we're just dead. This match is not going, this deck is not performing as well as I would have liked it to. Which feels weird. It's always weird to present a deck to you guys that's not... That has a good like a good pedigree, but then doesn't actually live up to those results in our matches, because I feel like I'm just bringing you a bad deck. Yeah, Inquisitions, that's not gonna do anything. So now we just get stuck on two lands with three threes and two fours. That seems good. We're not dead yet, but it's not looking good. We're going to seven, and they're probably going to cast something here. They're going to cast whichever one they favor, obviously. Yeah, so them being at 16 doesn't really matter. Like, we just don't have the opportunity to... Like, this is a matchup where, like, sure, we should have waited to Fatal Push the Eidolon to give them the opportunity to take two, but this is a matchup where, like, if we get in control, usually we're going to win. Okay, so you just have Stomping Ground. All right, well... Mana Tide would have been sick there, because then we could have actually cast it. And now we go to two, so or we go to three. Any three damage red burn spell kills us. And a swamp, all right. See, now we're in the game. Just kill us. Put us out of our misery. Inspiring Vantage. Well, I guess we live to fight another day. Do we just say no here? Go to two. Not ideal. We'll discard a Lingering Souls. And there's so many things that kill us, but if we are able to get back a Blood Ghast, or we're getting back Blood Ghast, but if we get to draw a land, yes. If we get to draw a land and then play Sorin and plus this guy and go to five, that's significantly better. But we kind of just, yep, they're paying costs, so we're dead. Yep, all right, sweet. We'll see you guys in round four, I guess. All right, guys, welcome to round four. This is the final round because our first round got messed up. So we're going to play first. Always with the itchy nose, man. Every time. Alright, we're going to keep this hand because it's very good. It's probably the best hand we've seen so far, despite this awkward, anguished unmaking. This is a time where we're going to Inquisition first turn. Could have got the Mana Tithe, I guess. But then we're still going to have to pay two no matter what. I guess we could have Fetid Heath and then Inquisition off that. But I'm still fine with this. We just have some options. What is going on here? Let's get rid of the Utopia Sprawl because it... Wow, what is this hand? Sprawl makes these Arbrelfs so much better. So we'll just get rid of Sprawl here. Oof. They probably just drew another Utopia Sprawl. Well, even if they did, they'd play that guy first. Ooh, the double Mana Tithe. Alright, well. Let's see what happens. That was their one forest, I believe. Oh, a Nykthos, I see. Yep. Yep. Play that Voyaging Satyr. Got him. So their hand is Emrakul and one other card. Okay. I guess we check it out. Yeah, it's not gonna like. They have four mana. Okay, another Nykthos. Seems good. So we can Blood Ghast here and feel good about our choices. All right, well, let's do it. Do it to it, as they say. Oh, Collective Brutes. So in your hand is this guy and Nykthos, need your Keswick Wolf Run. Okay. Well, we're not going to be discarding anything here. We're just going to kill an elf. And we can keep up Manatide. I guess we could have discarded Manatide to gain two, but I don't think that's really relevant. So our hand is Nykthos. Emrakul. That's good for us. And we'll just play the Marsh Flats. We don't have to actually crack it here, though. So if they play like something like a Garrick, we do have Sweet Mana Tithe, so... Man, we are, this is a... How are we losing this race? Oh, I guess because we took a million from, like, lands and things. I'm just going to keep playing lands. It's counterproductive with cards like Bloodghast, but we do have a Marsh Flats that we're going to leave. I'd rather have the Flagstones in play in case we draw Urborg and Smallpox, I guess. Oh, this is going to be the moment. Oh, Overgrowth. Yeah, unfortunately, that resolves. So we know you still have Emrakul Nykthos. If you try to untap that, I'm 100% going to Anguished on making it. Probably going to Anguished on making it anyway, because next time they get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mana. And I feel much better going to 9 against this deck. Yeah, I don't really want you to untap with that, so... That is also a land we will play. Can you just draw a Garrick here? To be fair, if I drew a Garrick, I would tap all three, untap this, tap it, play the other Nykthos to play around Manatide, especially because you've seen one. But... Yep, here we go. Could be good. This could be the moment. Oh, it's not the moment. It's not the moment at all. Man. They have 4 mana. And the last 2 turns, they've played something that cost 3 or sitting on a mana tithe. Where's the justice? Two, three. Let's just get in there with Bloodghast, I guess. Our life total's not super relevant. I'd rather have a Gideon.
Sorry, I don't know that one.
That was the Amazon Echo. I don't know if you could have heard that. And we'll make a dude. So they don't have a red source for... I guess they could red source on the forest to make Utopia Sprawl, but then they have to tap the forest to do it. So they un... Oh, look at that! So, now they make red... Can they get through? I don't think so. I don't think they have enough. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. 1, 2, 4. Okay. 5, 6. Ugh, still have 1 free. Here we go. Here we go. The end is nigh. I don't understand how this deck actually wins. It doesn't do anything particularly better than any other deck in the format. It's not burning the opponent faster than burn. It's not doing anything broken like casting Emrakul. It's not dumping a bunch of dudes into the graveyard like Living End. Like, it's just not doing anything. It's not doing any one thing particularly well is really my issue here. And then we draw Flagstones of Trocare. We just have no way to get past the Primeval Titan. Next turn they're going to have... So 1-2, activate this for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they go 6 mana, 7, 8, 9-10, untap, 11-12. Next turn they have 12 mana. Well, that's pretty good. It's pretty busted. Yeah, not good. It doesn't matter which flagstones I keep. It doesn't matter which flagstones you keep. Yep. I felt like this game was great. Like, they had a terrible opening hand, but then we just drew nothing but lands, and it just doesn't do anything. This deck is weird. I've played Smallpox decks before, and I've had some success with them, but I think those decks had, like, Monastery Mentor in them, which was significantly powerful. Like, that's a very strong card. Like, it can let you take over the board. Yep, that'll do. All right, let's see if they're getting Xenagos and Emrakul. Like, they have the Emrakul in hand, they just have to go find Xenagos. Let's see if that's what they're doing. Yep, okay, that's game. All right, so this is a match where we definitely want the Anguished Unmaking. But I don't know if we have enough to... I guess we can bring in Damnation. Mana Tide seems pretty bad. Fulminating Rage could be good. It takes care of things like Nick, though. So yeah, let's get rid of... let's get rid of the Mana Tides. Everything else seems good. Like, all the Smallpoxes and Fatal Pushes and Collective Brutalities, like, they should be great against this deck. Even Liliana just kills a dude. So, I think we're going to try it like this. Fulminating Rage is probably better than Damnation. Like, Damnation doesn't kill Xenagos. It does kill Emrakul, but they're usually casting it in this deck, or they're Tooth and Nailing, which gives it haste, so it doesn't really matter. They're either going to attack with it the third it comes into play, or they're going to take an extra turn, so... at no point is Damnation ever really relevant against Emrakul. Unless you're in the rare situation where they cast an Emrakul, they take their second turn, they do 15, you sacrifice 6 permanents, you cast Damnation, and you're not dead. That's a thing, I guess. But I think we're just going to go with Fulminating Rage because it kills some of their crucial lands. I will play first because that's what winners do. Despite it not having a great effect. I'm going to keep this hand because it's got a lot of disruption, but... the problem is, like, decks with a lot of disruption are great. Oh, well, I can disrupt your plan. But the problem is, if you don't follow up with some pressure to actually close out the game, they're just going to draw back into more things, right? Like, that's usually how it goes. I want to hit a Utopia Sprawl, so I want to actually play this first. I'm going to take 5 on turn 1, because this is a format. This is a really weird format. What is this? Hornet Queen? I'm just going to take the Primeval Titan. Next turn, I'm going to take Hornet Queen, I think. I don't know. You can have all the overgrowth you want, I guess. I don't know. Weird format is weird. This is your... So, we're not going to Thoughtseize because you're just going to play Voyaging Satyr, so we can just kill that. Untap, play Lingering Souls. You're going to overgrowth. Then we can play... Thoughtseize then and take your Hornet Queen. Crack that dude, get a forest. That's what I presume. Why did I pay 2 for that? I have no idea what's going on right now. Doesn't matter. We're not going to do anything with it anyway. I just wanted to send a message. That's all. Let them know I could. You were tapped out? I'll tap out too. I ain't afraid. Because they have 2 overgrowths, so there's no point in taking one of the overgrowths. And actually, next turn we can Thoughtseize, and that's it, because we only have 1 black source. So... Good times, good times. All right, so Overgrowth. I mean, you have Hornet Queen and Overgrowth and two other cards, which we'll find out now. Oh, that was such a good draw. Now we can keep everything up. We can Lingering Souls, and we can keep a Fatal Push. That's great news. Bet they drew Primeval Titan. Primal Command? God, Hornet Queen is such a beast. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next time they have 5 mana, so they can just actually play. They should go 1, 2, 3. Overgrowth on here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then if they play a land, they can Primal Command. Oh, this is just scary. I don't think we care about the Overgrowth. I think we care about the Hornet Queen more than anything. But then Primal Command just gets like a Primeval Titan. Puts a land on top of our deck, get Primeval Titan. How do we beat a Hornet Queen? What does this deck do? And unlike tokens, like, we're not attacking with a bunch of big dudes. We're just attacking with 1/1. So, like, if they do play one card like a Hornet Queen, it's pretty bad for us. I'm going to get rid of Hornet Queen and just hope that does... If they go land, they can just go land to Overgrowth, Primal Command into Primeval Titan. Yeah. Not feeling great about this deck or this match. I feel like we've just... This Modern Monday has been not as successful as most, unfortunately, but a learning experience nonetheless. I was so excited about this deck, too, because it had, like, Gideons and Sorins and Lilianas, and the sideboard was super sweet. Like, it was, like, the perfect threes and four ofs. Oh, the same Overgrowth on the same land. That's interesting. If only I had a way to kill that one single land. I do have multiple Fatal Pushes in hand, so if you try to do some shenanigans. What is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You have 7 mana. Sounds good. Primal Command, put Shambling Vent on top. Actually, that would be great because then we can just activate it. Oh, that's good. That's a good draw. I'm just going to keep playing lands. Oh, I don't think we win this race. We can't even crack a fetch to trigger Fatal Push. Is Fatal Push even good in this match? Or in this deck, like, is Path not better? Like, Path can get rid of Thragtusk, can get rid of not Xenagos. Well, yeah, I could get rid of Xenagos. Just do pre-combat. How many Marsh Flats do we have? We do have 4 Marsh Flats, but that's about it. I guess you can also play, like, Flagstones into Flagstones to trigger Fatal Push, but you can never do that on their turn. So you're pretty limited. You have to actually kill it on your turn. I mean, Fatal Push is great, don't get me wrong. Like, it's just really good in this format. It kills all the things you want to kill. I'm really hoping that they try to Primal Command and put our Shambling Vent on top. That would be the bee's knees. That dude's dead. All right, I think the correct play is searching for a creature and gaining 7. Because I put you just so far out of range for us. Mm-hmm. Alright, so you got 7. They can also just search for Voyaging Satyr, play Voyaging Satyr, and it gives them a million mana. So then go 5, untap 5, untap 5, and it's literally Emrakul mana just right here with the Voyaging Satyr and the Arbor Elf. Yep, solid play. K, can't begrudge them of that. This is a situation where we could have waited to do that until they saw what was happening, but whatever they get for Eternal Witness, that's fine. They can't cast it, so that was an interesting choice. So, black, one, white. Activate this dude. And we tapped in the worst possible way possible, but we do get to still keep up Fatal Push, so. So now what they get to do is pay 5, use 3 of it for Eternal Witness, use the other 2 to pump in a Nykthos, and then they'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nykthos will give you 5, and then you'll have 1 floating, so you get to Primal Command again. Probably going to gain 7 here, I would imagine. Because otherwise you might die. So we know your hand is Xenagos Eternal Witness. If they had a red source, they could have actually just Xenagosed and probably killed us, right? We just take 10. That's a dude. Untap forest, untap both. Sure. So in your hand is Eternal Witness Xenagos. Which is just fine. I feel like it would have been better to tap the forest instead of the Nykthos, because then you can actually activate Nykthos. Which is significantly better. But I'm pretty sure we're dead here. Like 12, this is 13 mana, so they can actually get back. They already did, they got back Primal Command, obviously, which gives them 7 extra mana. So they're actually 1 mana shy from being able to Tooth and Nail if they had that, but we know their hand is Xenagos, one other card. Yep. Targeting Shambling Vent, and now we don't have the mana to activate. Sad. It's good plays, though. Like, I mean, targeting the Gala Shrine when I can't activate Shambling Vent, targeting Shambling Vent when I can't activate Shambling Vent. Yep, we can't beat a Hornet Queen. I didn't think they'd have 2 in their deck, but I guess joke's on me. So, yeah, we just have nothing to deal with. No card that deals with this. And we're drawing a Shambling Vent, and we're at 4, so. Yep, alright, that's game. Unfortunately, these matches did not go as well as I would have expected. Hopefully you guys still got something out of them, and hopefully losing matches is not the only criteria you guys value, which it doesn't seem to be. So, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, appreciate it, and we'll see you next time.